What we're going to talk about today is Black Myth Wukong. Basically, there's been some controversy on Twitter. There's a writer for Screen Rant who has not given Wukong the best score, and people are not happy about it, but the score is not so much what I care about here. Now, the writer's name has been removed for safety reasons, as if people are going to physically assault them for saying some dumb shit. Now, there is some dumb shit. The author's name is Samar Abedian, I believe. She's a senior gaming guides writer for Screen Rant. And it's not the first time that this individual's apparently written something stupid, but we're just going to focus on one particular thing here that I'm going to read out to you. So they didn't give it the best review, which I'm not going to contest right now because I haven't played the game, so you can't really glaze a game as much as you might want to if you haven't played it. But there's one thing in here that she put for cons that I thought was hilarious. And she put, lacking in inclusivity and diversity. Now, do you want to tell me what the hell you're talking about when we're talking about a 16th century story about the Monkey King, the journey to the West, and you're talking about lacking in inclusivity and diversity? You're talking about an old mythological tale, and you're trying to hold it to 2024 standards with this BS. So I'm going to read out to you some of the stuff that she has written in here. So we'll start at the top. While my analysis and review of Black Myth Wukong remain focused on gameplay, it's important to mention the controversy surrounding the game studio and the reports of misogyny and sexism from the developers. Playing as a female gamer allowed me to notice issues surrounding inclusion and representation. Now imagine, these Chinese developers are retelling the story of Wukong, Journey to the West. We've all seen the monkey magic, we've seen Journey to the West stories for years. Obviously, Journey to the West was the inspiration behind Goku's character in Dragon Ball. So we're all familiar. And for whatever reason, rather than just reviewing the actual game and what's in the game, she's talking about things that were going on at the game studios, which we don't know if they were true. Based on some of the information that's come out from the translations from people in China, it's not true. And they seem to double down on the misrepresentation of the translations that they got. But even if what happened at Game Science was true, right? Even if there was some misogyny and sexism going on, what does that have to do with the actual game itself? Anyway, she says, as far as chapter 1 and 2, while characters are clearly fictitious and fantastical creatures, there were no female or feminine NPCs, enemies or bosses present. Well, I imagine if you're playing as Sun Wukong and you are going through his journey, most of the people that you're going to encounter on the field, on the battlefield, are going to be men, like in most places. When you are going through like adventure games or you're going through war games or whatever, most of the enemies that you encounter are men. And I imagine a story written in the 16th century is going to center around men and monsters, not really women. The only exception, if you can call it female, is a boss named Mother of Stones in Chapter 2, which is nothing more than a still glowing rock with no abilities being guarded by other enemies. This woman is a primetime hater. The lack of diversity and inclusivity, you know what, yeah, the minute you write that, you just increase the sales of the game. You realize that, right? I don't know if you are like a double agent, and you know that people are going to hear lack of diversity and inclusivity, take my money. And to be honest with you, I mean, I'm not so petty that I would buy a game because of that reason, but I'm definitely going to listen more if you tell me this game doesn't have any diversity or inclusivity, because those are two buzzwords that they like to use these days. And I just want to play a good story about the journey to the West. I'm not interested if there's no women in it. I couldn't care less. I have no issue with women being in games, but if the story is being accurately told, or they've just got a very exciting retelling of the Monkey King, and no women feature, I don't care. I don't care if there's no black people in it. I don't care if there's no disabled people in it. I don't care about any of that stuff. I'm just keep it 100 of you. I care if you're going to tell a good story about the Monkey King fighting monsters, probably coming up against some strong male characters. It is what it is. I imagine, or because I've seen the trailers of this game, there are women in the game. Maybe they're too beautiful for the reviewers' liking. I know how they like to uglify women. over here in the West for whatever reason, I couldn't tell you. The lack of diversity and inclusivity resonates with the misogynistic comments reported to have been made by developers, which expressed disdain for women playing their games. Although Black Myth Wukong does have truly enjoyable moments, the underlying feeling that women aren't welcome in this world felt present throughout my gameplay experience. And to any girls that are listening to this, as a matter of fact, my friend who's here in the hotel with me, she lived in China for some time and she's very familiar with Wukong, and Wukong is for everyone. Everyone can enjoy the game. Don't listen to this donut who is trying to make out that women are not welcome. This is the same thing that they say with Yakuza. Because Yakuza is a game that is heavily dominated by the male presence, because obviously it's about gangsters, and in the Japanese criminal underworld, I don't imagine you get too many women, just like in our underworlds. They tried to make out like it's not a game that welcomes women at one point, which is stupid, because I know plenty of female Yakuza fans. When I go to Comic-Con, I always see women dressed up as Majima. Just because they don't have a female protagonist or it's not catered to them does not mean they're not welcome. And obviously, with a story as old as the Monkey King from the 16th century, women are going to be welcome to experience that story. Just because they're not represented in the story does not mean they're not welcome to experience it. You've got to get your head out of your ass. It's worth noting the game is based on the novel Journey to the West, which does consist of a few important female characters. To not include any women, or to only include a few in an adaptation meant for a modern audience, is quite disconcerting. Are you stupid or something? If they are adapting something from the 16th century and they're trying to do it somewhat accurately, obviously they're probably going to take liberties because it's a video game. Why would they have women in the game if there are no women in it? Now, I know there's women in Journey to the West. I've seen Monkey Magic. I've seen the retellings of the Monkey King. But even why would you want to update it for modern audiences? You people don't get it. Honestly, you reviewers are some of the stupidest people I've ever met in my life, and I've met some of you. I'm not going to name any names because those people were polite to me in person, but in general, game journalists are really just bottom of the barrel stupid. Why would they want to update it for modern audiences? We want an accurate or somewhat accurate retelling of the Monkey King. You can take liberties, obviously, because it's a game. You're bringing out the game in 2024. Maybe you need to change things up for gameplay purposes. But in terms of including different demographics or different genders, a different gender, that being the female gender, if they're in the original story, no problem. If there's thousands of women in the original story, no problem. But if there's not, we don't need to include them. And if there's no guys in it as well, and it's just fighting monsters, it is what it is. While this doesn't take away from the exhilaration and fun of boss fights themselves, women fans of Souls-like games may have a different perspective, especially given that, according to reports, the developer also suggested that women aren't capable of enjoying or being skilled at these types of games. That's not what he said. Now, because I'm here at the hotel, I don't have all my things with me. I have the original Chinese translation of it. That's not what he said. And there are plenty of girls that play Souls games. I know plenty of girls that play Souls games. So even if he did say something like that, that is obviously not true. Now, again, they have smeared this studio because this studio rejected a Western narrative consultant agency like Sweet Baby Inc. They refused to take the deal from them. Sweet Baby Inc. wanted to basically extort them, or not Sweet Baby Inc., but a company just like them. I can't remember what the name of them was. And they said no, and immediately when they said no, all of these stories started coming out. This is just another person on the payroll as far as I'm concerned. I can't see it being any other way. The irony behind this sentiment is that Black Myth Wukong is among the easiest of Souls-like games and may have overestimated its ability to hang with them in terms of difficulty. Black Myth Wukong is not a Souls game. I said it in my previous video. I said it in the video that I did on Black Myth before that. It's not a Souls game. This game is more in line with a Devil May Cry or Ninja Gaiden. It's not a Souls game. And you can see that when you're watching it on screen. It's much, much more in line with those hack and slash games. I wouldn't say Souls games are really hack and slash. They really are their own genre. I wouldn't really put them in the same boat as Devil May Cry. So this person, again, chatting more shit, doesn't know what they're on about. I'm willing to bet, you know, because some of these reviewers, they're so quick to get these reviews out. We've seen this before. They don't even play the games properly. They later admit, oh, I got halfway through, or I got a quarter way through, or I played one mission, and this is what I based my review with. While thematically and stylistically, it undoubtedly falls under this category, it does not quite fit the bill in the technical skills required, such as is achieved by games like Elden Ring, Sekiro, Shadows Die Twice, and many more. Yeah, that, again, that's because it's not a Souls game. You weren't paying attention, clearly. I mean, you can see visually that it's not a Souls game. You can tell straight away it's not a Souls game. It's like saying Phantom Zero is a Souls game just because you're fighting people from that camera angle. Loads of enemies that are very fast paced or whatever, or it looks somewhat difficult. There's a difference between the Devil May Star Cry games and Elden Ring style, Souls style games. This is clearly not a Souls game. So again, your review, bunch of cowabunga. Now again, this person has had their name removed from the editor's note, but obviously the internet always uncovers these things, and I just gotta say that, like, we're very excited for Black Myth. There's nothing that you reviewers can do to stop the hype train. The game is super pre-ordered. You know, just take your fingers out your bum for 2 seconds and try to realize that people are not gonna continue to listen to this absolute horseshit that comes out of your mouth. So this does feel like you've been paid off by, let's not name any names, but it sounds like you've been paid off by somebody to write this bullshit review. Now, the reason I didn't go over the gameplay sections of the review, and they do some trashing in the gameplay sections, is because I haven't played it yet. And as much as I want to say they're full of shit and they're talking rubbish, I just don't know yet. But what I do know is that Black Myth Wukong comes from the 16th century, I believe it's 16th or 15th. I'm pretty sure it's 16th. Either way, it's a very old story. It's a story that is going to transcend time, and it's not something that needs to be updated for modern audiences or wet blankets like this reviewer. So go out and buy Black Myth Wukong. I think it's a game that all gamers should support. Stick it to the sweet baby ink types and these Western games journalists who think that they can manipulate us and gaslight us into buying their schlock. And we'll have a good time on it. So hope you enjoyed the videos, guys. I'll catch you all very soon. Take care and peace.
Let me relax.
Yeah, I know that I have wacky friends.
Well, yeah, I guess your quality is always quite bad. Didn't you say that's kind of like your thing?
My what?
Like your actual production quality is normally quite bad.
No, it's not.
That's what you were saying.
No, it's not over the top professional like you. I get this finger out here, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, because ew.
Well, they can see you in the mirror anyway.
Yeah, well, I'm going. Don't start yet. I'm going to be annoyed.
I've already started.
How can you already start? Like, no one wants to see this, like, fluff bit at the beginning where we're arguing about content quality.
Does the door have a lock?
No.
Okay.
Why? Are you planning to come into the bathroom with the camera?
No, I was just wondering. Weirdo.
Oh no, I'm taking up all the camera space. I look like a giant woman.
So what do you think of it?
What do you mean? Nigerian Cyrax? You already know I'm on board. It's basically me.
Do you honestly...
Guys, you think I look like Cyrax? I mean, I have the hair.
Do you honestly think that this is a better version than what we had?
Yeah, but I don't know why you always make it about, like, is it better? It's a metaverse, so it's. I don't think it's a competition. It's, like, just a different version of different gameplay, different, like, dynamics.
No, it's, like, the old Scorpion's better than the new one, no?
Yeah, but then...
How does what I said mean any different?
Because it's just different. Like,
oh, right, because it's a woman.
Yeah, because they've given her, a whole separate story arc.
Yeah, no, but what I'm saying, right, okay, the reason that people are upset, the trailer was put together well, yeah?
Right.
It did feel too much like Marvel. It feels more like Marvel than Mortal Kombat.
Yeah, but don't you think that's, like, the feel of the whole game?
Yeah, but so, people are not happy with that.
Yeah, but then they can't just, like...
No, they can. You can start to move it back, because this is an expansion, move it back into, like, the supernatural horror thing that Mortal Kombat had going on. This feels like a Marvel.
Yeah, but I feel like the whole game is already in that universe. Even having a metaverse with different variations of characters is already, like, a whole Marvel thing. So I just feel like it's too far gone now for you to, like, go back. That's obviously the angle they've gone with this game.
Yeah, I thought the trailer was put together okay. I don't like the whole gender bend Cyrax and Sector.
Hater.
I'm not a hater.
I love the new Cyrax, but not because she's a woman, because
Why do you love
Just because I think it's just cool that she's Nigerian. Hello, I'm Nigerian, so I'm biased.
What do you think about that voice?
I mean, the voice is like just funny. It's giving like Wakanda forever.
I got messaged by some African players, and they said that they're not happy with the voice because it feels like it's a caricature of their voices.
But the problem is like that's more so like that's how exactly how I felt about like a lot of the kind of like African representation like in the Marvel movies, like even Black Panther. I mean, I love the Black Panther movie, but they've centered it like purely on Nigerian culture, and considering that Wakanda's like a fictitious place, it's supposed to be like an amalgamation of different African nations, but they've modeled it so heavily.
Wakanda is based on where I'm from, Uganda. It's filmed there.
But what I'm saying is, either way, like, as a fictitious construct, it's supposed to be... No, but that's what I mean. Like, they've just lent in... What I mean by the fact that they've centered it on Nigeria is, like, the actual language that they're speaking is Yoruba. So they haven't made it where it's, like, a fictional thing. Like, I think they should have actually made up a Wakandian language, but they just modelled it on an existing Nigerian language. So clearly, a lot of the directors that contributed to the movie were Nigerian. So clearly, there's just like that overarching influence. And
I'm squatting
because we only have one chair in our crappy hotel that this one booked. But that's a side story. That's going to be a side quest.
A side quest
for another video. Me doing the tour of our crappy room, which I had to upgrade because it was unlivable.
I invited this donut to come with me. As a gesture of goodwill, because, you know, I'm a good person, and all I've gotten for it is blah, blah, blah.
What actually happened was I, the great friend and supporter, came to cheerlead on the side while this one tanked in Tekken 8. So, yeah.
I didn't tank.
Okay, he didn't tank.
I was... Okay.
Ranked 97th.
Yeah, there was a lot of good players. And
tank now.
I had Maggie in my ear, so I was fighting two battles at once.
Except, bear in mind that the whole time that I was there, those were the only games he won. I went to the toilet and he lost. So
I don't know. I don't know where you got in your head, right?
That you lost your first game. I wasn't there because I was late. Then when I came, you won all of the games. Then I went to the bathroom and then you lost and got kicked out of the tournament. So it's giving. I'm the luck.
Do you want to go have a shower?
Yeah, I'm out, guys. See ya. Tell me what you think of Nigerian Cyrax.
I'm not fond of it. Right, now that she's gone, let's get down to business. So, do you want to make more noise?
No, I'm closing the door.
Right, so I didn't do that good at versus fighting. I'm here in Birmingham right now. I came 97th. There was like 500 people that entered. I won 3 games, lost 2.
Apollo just got 2 perfects on this guy. Woo! Qualify! Final words.
You cannot escape from death.
The Nina player that beat me was just 10 times better than me. There was no hope. I couldn't even move. It's what I always tell people, yeah. Tech is so difficult that just when you think you're sick, you come across somebody that's literally on another level. And I feel like I was stuck in the mud. So I got eliminated, but I'm going to be staying in Birmingham. And the tournament organizer has entered me into Mortal Kombat. I haven't played Mortal Kombat since October, but they thought it would be funny for me to play in the tournament to see how well I do. So we'll see how well that goes. I don't even know if I'll actually play. I might just DQ myself. But yeah, I don't know. We'll see.